Let's talk about the money principle that if you apply, you're guaranteed to become rich. Not only rich, you will supersede the net worth of people that make the same amount of money as you. Now, this is a very basic principle. People will say it's basic, whatever, but you f***ers don't even do the basic shit, right? You barely f***ing brush your teeth. I gotta give you basic shit for your mushy ass brains because you're watching TikTok all day. So I wanna teach you guys a very basic principle on how to make sure that you make more money and save more money than the people that are making the same as you. You can even become wealthier than the individuals that make more money than you by applying this very simple principle. Now, everybody wants to talk all this deep logistics shit. They want to talk about, you know, all this stuff that is macroeconomics, microeconomics, getting super intelligent, but they're not willing to understand the basics, right? So I'm going to teach you guys the basics today, because if you don't have a good foundation in life, then your life is going to be shit. That's just how it is. Right, so my goal is for you guys not to have a shitty life. So if I can prevent you guys from having a shitty life and committing the same mistakes that everybody else commits, we're gonna have a couple scenarios. Green represents money, okay? As we know, this is time, okay? So it's linear, we got income, vertical. Okay, so you start your entrepreneurial journey, right? Let's say you start your entrepreneurial journey right here at the age of 19, right? That's a fair assessment, right? You're done high school, you've gone through the indoctrination camps, but now it's time for you to make money. You don't want to work for a job. So what you want to go ahead and do is start a venture. But as you become independent, you not only provide, you have income, but you also have expenses. So let's talk about your income. People's income is rarely linear, right? It's very rarely linear. Unless you work a steady job, if you're becoming an entrepreneur, your income will not become steady like that. It's not very realistic, especially when you begin. Usually you'll have something like this, right? You could have like this. That's how your income would actually be, right? In entrepreneurship, if you're winning, that's how I've seen my career path be, right? You see a decrease in net worth, right? So like I'll go up like this, right? It'll be stuff like that, right? That's usually how my net worth works. Now, what is the problem with making money? The problem with making money isn't your ability to make it, it's your ability to keep it. And most people do not know how to protect their wealth. So let me teach you guys how to protect your wealth in a very basic way. We're gonna keep it linear, just for the sake of the illustration, but I don't wanna make it complicated. If I make it complicated, you won't remember it. If I make it simple, you'll remember it forever. So let's say your income is linear. We're just gonna use it for the sake of the illustration. Now let's talk about your expenses. Most people match their income with the level of expenses that they have, okay? Because they think that their income is linear, that they have to have a linear spend. And usually what people are trying to do is they're trying to showcase to the world their income level, right? So as your income grows, you want to portray that growth in a way that people validate you. This is normal behavior, but it's not good behavior. The average motherfucker who's a loser, right? And this isn't you, because you're gonna learn at a young age. Their expenses are right here. So what does that mean? That means that you have a slight room for error and a slight room for saving money, right? Remember, your money's linear. Look at how much room you have for error. You have very little room for error. And as we understand that your net worth, right, or the amount of money that you make as an entrepreneur isn't always steady, you could see dips like this. Right? You could see stuff like this happen. Well, what happens in these pockets? And it's happened to me, right? Well, you're losing money. And what happens with expenses? Usually in life, it's extremely difficult in life to reduce your expenses. Just like we had the kid in the chat, right? Talking about they have a $700 car payment. Well, what are you gonna do now? Now you have a fucking headache. So now you have to deal with a $700 car payment because you didn't learn how to manage your expenses. Now, let's just say this is 100 grand. I'm gonna make this very simple. And I'm gonna teach you guys off of like real experience, right? So let's say this is 100 grand. When I was making 100K a year, many years ago, okay? My rent was $200. I was sleeping on a couch and I was making six figures. I was driving an old Volvo, okay? And I was staying up till 5 in the fucking morning with a job at 10 in the morning, working on my side hustle. But The point is, my expenses were fairly correlated, and then as soon as I hit 100 grand, my expenses reduced drastically. Why? Because I realized that I couldn't always count on making more money, but I could count on maintaining the money that I was making, right? And then what I could do was limit my expenses. So what's the difference between this guy and the first guy? Is that as time goes on and your income increases and your expenses stay the same, now you have freedom. This right here, this gap right here, ladies and gentlemen, is your freedom gap. The bigger the gap is, the more freedom you're going to experience in your life. So right now, my current expenses in life are fixed, probably about 40 grand a month, right? 40 grand a month is what I spend probably every single month, right? That between houses, between buying random shit, I don't know, bro. 40 grand a month is what I spend, give or take. I don't like saying that number because to me it's a gross number, it's way too much. So this gap right here represents freedom. Your goal is to be doing two things simultaneously when you're getting rich. Two things. One is making sure that you're always on a steady uptrend, right? If you fall below, right? If you fall below, make sure that your expenses give you enough wiggle room for risk. Like I can't make it more simple. Increase your income or keep your income the same or slowly increase your income and maintain your expenses the same. Now I needed to graph it in a way where you grasp the fucking concept so you understand that there is no shame living with your parents if you're clocking in money as long as you're productive. There is no shame living in a one bedroom house as long as it's a good fucking work environment that's productive and helps you elevate. As long as your expenses are stable. As long as your expenses are stable. The hardest thing to get rid of is expenses. That's why a lot of these celebrities, they go fucking broke. They go fucking broke. So even though this is common sense to a lot of people, you would be surprised that a lot of people do not apply this. The moment they get 100 racks, they spend 100 racks. They're poor. Instantly. Done. So this right here needs to be your measurement and your scale of life. And as you can tell, it's drawn in a slight uptrend. What does that mean? That means that your life quality does increase. But if God forbid, right, you are in a situation, ladies and gentlemen, where you're going up to 150K, boom, and your net worth bounces down 30%, or your income bounces down 30%, right? Then what happens? Look at all the fucking wiggle room. You're still living with freedom. So everybody that's waking up with anxiety, it's because they haven't figured this out. They haven't figured it out, that's why they're stressed. So it's not expensive to understand this concept. You don't need a master's degree. You just need good money management skills and to not give a fuck, a flying fuck about what anybody says. If you can crack this code, it's because it's a mental code, bro. It's you need to come to terms with the fact that you ain't gonna be flexing like everybody else when you're 21. You're gonna be sitting, you're gonna be grinding, and you're gonna be building a real fucking business and making real fucking money. That's the name of the game. This to me, ladies and gentlemen, is freedom. Now let's go to the situation that a lot of people live in. This is the situation that a lot of people live in. What is the situation? Well, it's the opposite. This is a situation that most people live in. Let's say they have their steady level of expenses, and then they have their income. Most people don't know how to make money, and they get into fucking crazy debt. This bro right here is the life of an average American. You know what this is called? I'm gonna put it in red so you understand it. Breaking it down as fucking simple as I can, bro. You know what this is called? And I can't wait for people to make fun of me with these basic ass concepts, bro. But you know what? Most of you guys are too fucking dumb to realize how valuable this information actually is. This is called slavery. That's what it is. You are a slave. You are in debt. Indebted. You are owing somebody, which means you must work until you pay that debt off. So the question is, do you want to live in freedom? Not luxury. Do you want to live in freedom or in slavery? That's the name of the game. Now what happens, bro, when you're in a different situation and you have all this money? What do you do with all of this? You grab it and now you invest it. And investments, something like this, are the same thing. Time now versus investment. This money that you had that you were trying to flex on motherfuckers, Now you've turned this, okay, into investments over time. And here, ladies and gentlemen, is where the rich get wealthy. And that is the secret to wealth, bro. That is the secret to wealth in a very basic way, in a way that any peasant can understand. Today I sat down, I was like, how can I simplify these concepts in a way that people can understand? Because I know we got a lot of young bucks in here that want to understand and learn how to make money. The first thing is, don't make the same mistakes your parents made, which was get a mortgage, work a traditional 9-to-5, eat genetically modified food, watch television, and take medication that they don't even know what the fuck they're taking. If you can avoid and do the complete opposite on all five of these things, you're gonna live a completely better life than your entire family. So I simplified this concept in a way for you to understand so you can go out in life and win. So this is the sauce. This is a mindset game. Understand this concept and you win. Your freedom now goes back and compounds as time over investment. And that's when you go from working for your money to money working for you, which is the key to becoming free.